So in our last video, we learned everything about the 4G module, and now in this video, we're gonna make a very interesting project out of it. That is to make our own GPS tracker that works straight on 4G connectivity so that you don't require any Wi-Fi connectivity nearby. And you'll be able to track the location of that module straight onto the new Blink application. So that's a very interesting project that we're gonna make in this video. But before starting, if you're new to this channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button as we come up with this kind of electronics, IoT, automation related project tutorials every week. That being said, let's start with this video. Do you know what most electronic companies have something in common? Well, it's the tool that they use for making their products, and the most commonly used tool that almost all the big electronic companies uses is the Altium PCB Designer software. Using Altium, you can definitely level up your PCB designing skills and make something really professional out of it. And now, along with the integration of Octopart, searching for any electronic components globally becomes really very easy. Octopart is kind of Google for just electronic components, where you can search for any electronic parts and get that information all on one single web page. So do check out this amazing search engine made just for electronic components. I'll leave the link for this down in the description. Do check it out. Okay, so coming back to the video. So now to make this project, we'll need the Marduino Zero 4G LTE board, and that's the standalone board because that has the built-in SIM7600 model that provides the 4G connectivity, and it also has the built-in GPS module, so we don't require any external hardware. We'll just need a battery and a battery connector to power it up, so to make this project a more mobile project, a remote project, right? So that's the only hardware we'll need. Everything, every logic is made with the help of the code only, and let me tell you, the code is also not that straightforward because we don't have the support for the Blink library directly with the SIM7600 as of now. So what we did is we tried to embed the GPS coordinate data in the API. We send that data to the Blink cloud server, and then we receive it on the mobile application, and that's how this project works. Sounds confusing? Well, let me show you the proper workflow of the project. So now I'll explain how we made the code of the GPS tracker using the 4G module by showing you what you can say working flow on this board. So I divided this thing into three sections: network, GPS, and the API. Starting with the network. So in the starting of the code, what we are doing is we are initializing the SIMCOM module first of all, okay? So after initializing, we are checking if we are getting the proper network or not, because hey, come on, we need the network to send the data. So if there's no network, there's no use of this project. So after checking if there's network available, we are jumping on to the GPS side. And here again, what we are doing is we are initializing the GPS module, and initializing GPS module and getting the coordinates take around 60 seconds of time. So we are providing a delay of 60 seconds here. And after that, again, we are cross-checking whether we are getting the coordinates or not. So if we didn't get the coordinate, we'll still wait here. And once we get the coordinate, it will be storing that coordinate into a variable, okay? But here is one catch. The coordinate that we are getting and the coordinate which is supported by the Blink cloud has a two different formats. So here we need to provide some conversion to make the coordinates supported in the Blink cloud as well. So here, after getting the coordinates, what we are doing is we are providing a coordinate conversion, we can say, and storing those new coordinates into the new variables. Got it? So after getting the coordinates, now it's the time to jump onto the API section, okay? So here what we are doing is, first of all, here we are initializing the HTTP protocol, okay? Now it has a couple of commands to initialize the HTTP protocol. After initializing, what we are doing is we are just requesting the new Blink API, and we are embedding this new coordinate inside this Blink API. Now, Blink API, if you are confused or don't know what is this Blink API, then in short, Blink APIs are kind of an HTTP link on which we can embed our data, embed our authentication token, and it will send that data directly to our Blink cloud account, okay? And if you want to learn more about Blink APIs and know how to send and receive the data using that, well, I will recommend you one of my previous video, which is dedicatedly made for the new Blink APIs, whose link you can find easily in the I button as well as in the description of this video, that will cover all the different APIs used in the Blink and how to use them. I also taught that in particular that video only. Okay, so here we are using the Blink API, embedding the new coordinates, latitude, longitude, and after that we are just terminating the HTTP protocol by just typing HTTP term. Okay, so this will send our data directly to the Blink cloud, we can say, without using any Blink library. And yes, after terminating, this whole loop goes on and on, like checking the network, checking GPS, sending the data, checking network, checking GPS, sending the data. So this loop goes on and on. So code for this workflow is translated by our team, and we'll be providing that code link down in the description of this video for absolutely free. And it do require a lot of hard work, a lot of error solving, a lot of bug solving to completely translate this logic into a code format. And for that, our team did a really hard work. So make sure you hit the like button just for our team, because we'll be providing that code to you for your project absolutely free. Okay, so now after knowing about how this project works, the last step remaining is we just need to configure our Blink mobile application. So let me show you how to configure a Blink mobile application, and after that I'll show you the actual working of the project. So first I open up the new Blink mobile application. Inside it, click here, again click here, and click on add template. Give this a name, I'll name it as 4G GPS location. After that, just go inside the template and click on the plus icon. Here we need to add the map widget, but let me make it clear, the map widget is not available in free plan. You need to upgrade it to the plus plan. After that, just tap on it and select data stream as V9. After that, just go back to the home page, click here and click on add new device. Select manually from template and select our 4G GPS location template. Give this device a name, I will name it as the same. And that's it. We successfully configured our Blink mobile application. Now let's jump on to the code part. In the code, we need to provide the authentication token, which we can get from our Blink web dashboard. So just open up the device and click on device info. Here, just copy the auth token and paste it inside the code. And that's the only change you need to do. After that, just select the write board and write COM port and directly hit the upload button. After the code gets successfully uploaded, we connected the battery with our 4G module and open up the Blink project on our phone. Now it will take around a minute to get the location, so you need to wait till that. So here is the location. The black icon is the location we are getting from our 4G module, and the blue one is the location which we are getting from our smartphone's GPS. So it seems quite accurate. Now it's the time to test this project in outdoors. So I packed this project in a plastic case, and now let's take this board on a long ride. As you can see, we are able to see the live location straight onto our Blink mobile application, and it will work from any corner of the world via internet. Superb, isn't it? So that was our GPS tracker made just using the Marduino Zero 4G LTE board, and it works perfectly fine. Like, we are able to get the real-time location straight onto our Blink mobile application. You can make it easy, like we just need the board, a battery, and we are good to go. So that was the project made using this board. Do let me know what other project should we try using this 4G module, and just let me know your thoughts, your ideas down in the comment section of this video, and we'll try to do research about it, and if it gets successfully made, we'll definitely make a video out of it as well. So do comment below. Also click the like button if you really like this video, really like this project, because I too like it, because it doesn't require any Wi-Fi connectivity, or there's no foundation of any connectivity. Like the GSM, like a 4G module, works everywhere until unless we are having the 4G towers. Okay, so yeah, that being said, I'm just ending this video here, and now just wait for my next Explore, Learn, Share with me, Techie SMS.